Is that a good idea?
Yes, so let me come. Mm-hmm. So with the earmarking, you are going to say it will go into A, B, C, D areas in certain ratios. Mm. The one which is non-earmarking, it goes into the consolidated fund, and then government then would use it to probably fill in the gaps from the non-oil budget, for example. But Ghana wants to go beyond that. We want to also have what we call a stabilization fund, mm-hmm. and then a future generation fund.
So you want both?
So we want both. Mm-hmm. So what is going to happen is that a certain percentage could be for the stabilization and then the future fund, and then a certain proportion would then go into the consolidated fund. But to be able to do that, you need to get the real production figures.
Yes, to know how much.
So how much revenue you are going to get.
But and do all we not this, know that? We're all this is at always about 20 billion over the next.
Yes, but you know we are discovering more fields.
Yes, but on the basis of what
so you have. So you need to take an optimum, you know. And again, test producing is very, very important because we have seen countries like Mauritania who came up hyping. And then when production started within a year, it got choked up. So I would think that we should do this very gradually, but the laws should be put in place.
But you must do it before you produce oil.
Yeah, yes. And I believe that, as you are aware, you know the legislation for oil revenue management is one of the prior conditions for our relationship with World Bank and IMF.
Yeah.
So even based on that, we ourselves as a government need to do it. Yeah. Because here is World Bank pumping almost a billion plus.
Yeah, but you need to do IMF. It even without that.
Yes, yeah, but what I'm saying is that there is even an incentive to do it, an additional incentive to do it. So I believe that by the time Parliament will reconvene in October, we'll have the revenue management law, the draft being brought to Parliament. Then we'll flesh it out, take it back to the Ministry of Finance and Energy. Then they'll fine-tune it, bring it back, and then it will become law.
Mr. Asaga, thank you very much.
Thank you,
I appreciate
David.
You coming, sir.
It's a pleasure. And I'll always be here.
Thank you.
Yep. Yes.